I hope these people aren't home because they're going to think it's weird that the counselor's throwing papers at their door. And that's why you don't always do it. Now, the problem in those days was that a lot of people had doors that the top was glass. So you had to be really careful. And I actually remember on one occasion, I did break the glass and the person wasn't home. I left a note and I had a bill, and I can still remember this. And this is going back almost 40 years. It cost me $23.10.
Okay, so this is what I won in 1966, being a wee lad of 12 years old. A couple of years after I started my paper route, and this whole area here was eligible to basically sell subscriptions, and whoever got the most subscriptions, of course, got all kinds of prizes and also got this trophy. And so I've kept this trophy ever since.
Yeah, not the houses haven't changed in 40 years. But the Saturday Star was the big one, and of course it took a lot of work.
The Saturday paper was a big, heavy paper, as it still is today, and there were a lot more customers. So the net result of that was that the bag you carried over your shoulder on your bike was a lot heavier, and usually you'd have to go back and fill it up two or three times on Saturday because you couldn't fit as many papers in one bag.
I think I couldn't actually do it all in one trip. It probably took me about, I think, an hour. It was great. I was 14 years old. I was making, you know, 10 bucks a week or 8 bucks a week, whatever it was. And back then, that was pretty good.
There's a milk box just on the other side there. I know that milk box. I've delivered more papers in that milk box than anybody.
Bada boom, bada bing, and away you go.
Morning, Mr. Shirley.
Mark, how are you?
It's the paper boy.
Thank you very much.
Good on time as usual.
Yes.
Got the Binghams here, Bob Bingham. I see him at public meetings. I call him Mr. Bingham. He goes, Mark, it's Bob. I said, no. Is Mr. Bingham, always will be Mr. Bingham to me.
I could still walk down this street and name, you know, the Carlsons, the Salonikis, the Pozaks, the Taylors, and it brings back a lot of memories.
When I delivered the newspapers as a 10, 11, 12-year-old, a lot of these people lived in the community for the next 20, 30 years, some in the case of 40, so when I ran for councillor in this area, I actually knew them from when I was delivering the Toronto Star. Most of them let me put signs on their lawns.